Good morning. Let's take a closer look at uniformly accelerated motion.
Hey guys.
Hey Bo.
Hi Bo.
Flippin' physics.
We have already begun working with uniformly accelerated motion, or UAM, and we have our four UAM equations. And those are great. We're going to use those a lot. However, today I want to try to understand what it means to have a uniform acceleration, what it means to have a constant acceleration. So let's start with the equation for acceleration. Billy, what is the equation for acceleration?
Acceleration equals change in velocity over change in time.
Correct. And Bo, in base SI units, what are the dimensions for acceleration?
Meters per second squared.
Also correct. We've learned that acceleration is in meters per second squared. However, I find that students better understand what uniformly accelerated motion means when instead of using meters per second squared, we use meters per second every second, which is the same thing, but it's what acceleration means. Meters per second every second. In other words, if the acceleration of an object is a constant 10 meters per second squared, that means that the velocity of that object is changing by 10 meters per second every second. Let's take a look at a simple demonstration. This is a basketball accelerating down an incline. In order to make the numbers easy, let's pretend the ball has an acceleration of 2 meters per second every second. The acceleration of the ball is actually 0.3287 meters per second every second. However, that number is unruly to work with, so we're going to use 2 meters per second every second to make the numbers easier to understand. So what we're trying to understand is, what does this mean? The acceleration of the basketball is 2 meters per second every second. So Bobby, what is the initial velocity of the ball?
It looks like it isn't moving when you let go of it, so the initial velocity is zero.
Then Billy, how fast is the ball moving after 1 second?
Well, because the acceleration is constant, we could use the uniformly accelerated motion equation, velocity final equals velocity.
Billy, please stop. Remember, I'm trying to help you understand what uniformly accelerated motion means. Therefore, we're going to put away those UAM equations for a little bit. Again, if the initial velocity of the ball is zero and it has an acceleration of 2 meters per second every second, what is the speed of the ball after 1 second?
Oh, its speed is increased by 2 meters per second after 1 second, so the ball is moving at 2 meters per second.
Great. Now, 1 second later, at 2 seconds, Bobby, how fast is the ball moving?
It should be moving 2 meters per second faster, so 2 plus 2 is 4 meters per second.
Yes, and at 3, 4, and 5 seconds, Bo, what is the speed of the ball?
Each second, the speed increases by 2 meters per second, so 6, 8, and 10 meters per second are the velocities.
Absolutely. That is what an acceleration of 2 meters per second squared means. It means the velocity is changing by 2 meters per second every second. Now, let's make a table out of these data. The only data we are missing from our table are the positions. Let's assume the initial position is zero. Billy, now you may use a uniformly accelerated motion equation to determine all those positions.
We can use the UAM equation, displacement equals velocity initial times the change in time plus 1/2 times the acceleration times the change in time squared. The velocity initial is zero, and the acceleration is two, so the displacement then equals the change in time squared. So 1 squared is 1, 2 squared is 4, 3 squared is 9, 4 squared is 16, and 5 squared is 25. Those are all the positions in meters.
Hold up. There's no way that ball moved 25 meters.
Remember, Bo, 2 meters per second every second is not the actual acceleration of the ball.
Oh, yeah. I forgot.
Now let's try a slightly different example. The initial velocity of the ball is now 10 meters per second to the left, or negative 10 meters per second. The acceleration of the ball is still positive 2 meters per second every second. So, Bo, what is the velocity of the ball 1 second later?
Well, it shouldn't matter that the initial velocity is negative. The acceleration is still a change in velocity of 2 meters per second every second. So we add 2 meters per second to the negative 10 meters per second, and the ball is now moving at negative 8 meters per second.
Correct. Now, Billy, what is the velocity of the ball at each of the next 4 seconds?
Well, we continue to add 2 meters per second every second, so the velocities in meters per second should be negative 6, negative 4, negative 2, and 0.
Yes, and again, we can put all these data in a table. You can see I calculated all the positions for the basketball, starting with an initial position of 25 meters to match the final position the ball was in during the previous example. If you'd like to see those calculations, they are in the lecture notes posted on my website at flippingphysics.com. I hope that you now have a better understanding of what it means for an object to have uniformly accelerated motion. Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoyed learning with you.